Ragan, thanks so much for sitting down and talking to us today. First of all, we're sitting here at MTSU, which is where you're in school. Mm-hmm. Also my alma mater. So it's really fun to be back. But like, serious question, what is La Siesta still the best Mexican restaurant?
I don't hear about it.
That's a travesty.
I don't hear about it. I hear about Camino a lot.
Oh, Camino was good.
Yeah.
So tell me just a little bit about you.
Well, I was born in Houston, Texas, and my mom was going through a bad drug addiction from age 6 to 15. We moved in with my grandparents, so I like went through depression and anxiety because my grandparents were very abusive and just verbally and physically, and it just stimulated things, and I started self-harming and ended up doing things like reckless things. I got a car when I was 15. I wrecked it 3 days after I got it, and I was driving under the influence. And then I got put in DCS custody for running away.
So you went into DCS custody at 15, mm-hmm. and you were in East Tennessee.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Tell me just a little bit about that.
I started off in a group home, and it was actually kind of chaotic there. There was a lot of arguments and fights, and I ended up running away with 3 other girls. We got caught, and I got sent back. It was the next day I actually went to the bathroom and had a suicide attempt, and one of the girls found me. And I'm sorry. After the hospital, they sent me to Youth Villages in Memphis.
What is Youth Villages?
It's like placement for kids, not just group homes or facilities, but there's foster homes. It's just really based on helping kids, you know.
So talk to me just about those first couple of months. Were there changes that you saw in yourself?
I actually had changes for the worst at the time because I was against the staff. I didn't want the help. I didn't want the counseling because I thought, you know, I don't need to be here. And they really processed with us and was like, we're here for you. Like, we want what's best for y'all. So it really, like, registered to us.
So when did things start to change, or how did things start to change for you?
I would say when I went to my second Youth Villages in Inner Harbor, it was all about processing and bettering you as a person. I learned that, like, people aren't always against you, because I had that mindset, like, everybody hates me, everybody's against me, and that, it just made me realize, like, the world's not against me.
So while you're in Georgia, you're getting your education, so you're in high school at that point.
Yes. It was hard, but I graduated early, too. It was just hard, but I just stayed motivated with it and, like, concentrated and focused, because I was like, I don't want to be the kid that doesn't. And my therapist kept telling me, I know you want to do this, you're so smart. And I was like, you know what, she's right, like, I can.
So you graduated in December, which is so exciting. Congratulations.
Thank you.
You left Georgia and ended up in Nashville. How did you end up in Nashville?
After my graduation, I discharged from Inner Harbor in Georgia, and I got to go to my favorite group home of all time, which is a Nashville Wallace group home. These people are here to help me. Like, they literally are. I look back on situations and moments, like when I would self-harm. I mean, they would put themselves in danger to help me. I'm telling you, it was like home there, literally a home.
So you apply for college at MTSU. Mm-hmm. What was that process like for you?
Oh, it was so scary, because I thought the whole time, you know, I'm not gonna get in. I'm a kid in the system, like, that's not happening. And I thought that I would be in those facilities and group homes forever, and I was getting out of that, and it meant the world.
What are some of the challenges you feel like you're facing right now?
Financially is one, because I don't have a job because I didn't do work study, but I'm doing it next semester, so it won't be too much.
I know that you've applied to the scholars program at Youth Villages. What exactly is that?
It provides, like, additional financial and education and just life skill support. They help with, like, bills and, you know, things like that, because you have to fill out a monthly budget, you know, saying what your bills are and, you know, things that you need help with and stuff, and they're willing to help.
So what do you want to do? What are you studying?
It was psychology, but I changed it to child development and family studies so I could be a youth counselor as soon as possible. It's been a great experience so far. I've yet to have anything to complain about. I mean, my 9 o'clock class is kind of hard getting up for, but at the end, it's all worth it. Anytime I don't want to go to class or I'm just like, oh, I'm tired, I just have to remind myself, you know, I'm here for something, you know? And while I'm getting my master's, I plan to work at Wallace Group Home.
Yeah, because you want to go back and help the kids that are like you.
Yes, absolutely. I hope that I can make an impact on their lives as the counselors and the staff and made on my lives, and just to let them know, you know, you're not on your own with this. Look, success stories are possible, because I look at mine as a success story, because I learned so much being with all the different girls and all the different staff and just all the knowledge from everyone that I gained, and the dreams that I have now are just reachable.
So one of the things that we do at CrossPoint is something called the Dollar Club, where once a month we ask everybody in the church to put in a dollar, pull that money together, find a need in the community that needs to be filled, and go fill it. And I think the way that you have worked so hard to improve yourself, just personally and emotionally, and going to school, just the joy and beauty that radiates from you after so many things that you've walked through. And so we have a check for $7,000 to help go towards your education and bills and that sort of thing, so that we can help.
Thank you. Thank you.
Will that help?
Yeah, a lot more than you think. It's always in the back of my head, like, I can't do this because of this. Like, I don't have the money for that, or because my family, they don't help with that either. And it's just, I don't know, that's so generous. I've never had that happen to me.
We just wanted to be a part of that.
Thank you so much.
There you go.
Oh my gosh, it's awesome.